Facilities spent hours, day in and day out, repainting walls, cleaning showers, scrubbing floors, and tidying up what residence life officials considered a building in severe need of repair.
Towards the end of ownership by the previous company, that the building was not in the best condition, that it maybe was not taken excellent care of and all of that. So we were happy to get it back and to be able to get it up to our standard.
Floors went from yellow to white. There's now free laundry units on each floor, and each apartment has a newly installed flat-screen television.
The facilities department even fixed little things. This hallway behind me was never fully lit. Now all 10 lights are in working order, not just on this floor, but on every floor.
But when you walk into Columbia Hall, the new amenities are not the only additions you'll notice. Sign after sign indicating new building rules, a graduate resident in charge of the building, and a guest sign-in book at every entrance set an awkward tone with some students. This will be senior MPA major Christy Lee's third year in the building.
Welcome to my crib! This building was viewed as a place for the upperclassmen to go and have more independence. Just because Stevens is pretty strict about living on campus, this was like your little safe haven of pretend you're not living on campus, but you get all the benefits of living on campus.
Now, she says, some of the new rules have taken away parts of that independence, and some students have shown their disapproval by tearing down signs and changing messages on the building's whiteboards.
I know that we've had some issues with disrespect, inappropriate behavior and all of that, people being resistant to the policies, but I like to think that that's the minority. It's difficult to embrace change, and now that we have taken over the ownership of Columbia Hall, people that have lived there in the past that were used to the management of Premier Management, and now they're getting used to management by Stevens College.
With embracing that change, Lee admits it's all about integrity and representing yourself as an upperclassman when it comes to the new policies, like signing in guests.
I see where people are coming from, feeling like maybe they're being babied, and they're like kind of retaliating against that. But I think it comes with the expectation that we are upperclassmen living here, so we should be taking the responsibility to sign them in anyways.
Mazzola agreed, saying that upperclassmen enjoy more freedom in Columbia Hall to follow those rules on their own without residence life stationed at an entrance all day.
So we hope that in the coming weeks, people will get used to it, accept it, and be respectful to everyone.
After saying all those rule changes, which I'm not personally like a huge like fan of, I mean, I would never live anywhere else. I like it the same. There's new rules, but it's just part of being out of college. I'm not bitter about it at all. I'm still happy to be living here, definitely.